As formidable as the Legiones Astartes were, their numbers were far too small to conquer and protect an entire galaxy. So the Emperor had a second and greater force created, the Solar Auxilia. The cohorts of many planets served on both sides of the Horus Heresy to protect or destroy worlds. Hello, and in this video, we'll be painting a Solar Auxilia Legate Marshal in the cohort colours of the Boremanite Devils. We'll be painting this Loyalist Marshal to battle ready. Then we'll be adding a few extra tips so you can take your model to the next level. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. These colours can be used across your whole Boremanite Devils cohort. You could even use these colours for any other armies in your collection too. We've also got a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use any brushes you feel more comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you could check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about paints and techniques. As this cohort is mostly grey and darker green colours, we'll be undercoating our Legate Marshal in Mechanica Standard Grey. This is a perfect start for any vehicles you're painting as part of your force too. So let's start painting. We'll start with a base coat of Mechanica Standard Grey from the pot, and we'll be applying this all over the void suit with a small base brush. It may seem odd that we're using the same paint as the undercoat colour, but there is a good reason for it. The pot has a more solid grey finish that suits cloth and softer details more than the spray, which works really great for bigger vehicles. We'll only need one coat of this paint as it has a great solid coverage. Next, we'll paint the armour plating and the tail coat with Caliban Green. So we'll be careful of the void suit when applying this colour, as some of these details sit very close to this. So we'll be using a small base and medium layer brush for different size details. Just a few coats of this colour will give us a solid dark green tone we're after. If you do get any of this colour on the Mechanica Standard Grey, you can always tidy up now, or wait till we have a few base coats applied and tidy everything then. With our two main colours applied, we'll add the metallics. First, we'll use Lead Belcher for any leg armour, hinges, belt, weapons and the life support on the back. You will also see there are some sealing rings around the hands and the legs too, so be careful when applying a metallic here. As there is a lot of details in this colour, you can use whatever brush is best for the area. For most of the details, we'll be using a medium layer brush, as it can get us great coverage but will give us control. After a few coats of this colour, we'll move on to a second metallic. Now we'll add Liberator Gold for any ornate details, just like the chest eagle, helmet crest, armour trim and paragon blade guard and pommel. There is less of these details compared to the Lead Belcher, but we still want to be careful when applying our layers. Remember to use brushes that are best for the area you're painting. So we'll be using the side of a small layer brush for the trim and a medium layer for the chest eagle and blade. After this colour is dry, we'll apply our last metallic colour. And for those last extra metallic details, such as the helmet pipes, cogs and coils, we'll be using fulgurite copper. This is a strong coppery tone, so it will stand out from the gold and the silver details, rather than looking all the same, giving our model here some real character. Once you have finished your last layer and any tidying up, we'll change our paint water, as it's full of metallic flakes that we don't want in the rest of our colours. With our metallics done, we'll apply Corvus Black to the suit piping, lenses, boots, gun casing and the helmet plume. Just like with all the base coats we've already applied, we can tidy up any mistakes now for later on. Next, we'll paint the chest scroll and small segments in the plume with Wraithbone. This may be a really small detail overall, but still needs a few coats for a full and solid coverage, while still being careful of the other colours. For our leather details, we'll be applying Thondia Brown to the gloves, boot gaiters and straps all over our marshal. This tone of brown works great here, as we'll be making the recesses darker later on, but still keep those raised areas a little lighter. Now to add a bit of colour to the lenses and the segments in the plume, and for this we'll be using Wild Rider Red. On the plume, we'll just pop it on the inside of the Corvus Black areas, and right at the front of the plume itself. And for the eye lenses, we'll try and keep a bit of the black base coat surrounding it, just giving it a bit of depth. With those red details done, we'll be applying Avalon Sunset to the light on the Marshal's shoulder, and any other small lights found on the model. We'll also be using this for the inside of the Volkite gun barrel. If you get any of this on the grating on the front of the light, we could just tidy that up with Lead Belcher by using the side of a small layer brush with a small amount of paint. Then as our final base coat, we'll paint the officer's tassel with demonette hide. Just a few coats and we're all done base coating. Remember to tidy up any mistakes or stray colours on our model, as we're about to shade all our details. So we can shade everything effectively and keep the whole tone similar all over, we'll thin down one part Rattling Grime with two parts Lamia Medium. For the Caliban Green and Mechanicus Standard Grey details, we just want to use this as a recess shade. By using a small or medium layer brush, we can be neat and quick with our application. For the rest of our colours, we want to apply this mix all over, but still make sure we have control on the amount we have on our details, as we don't want any details obscured or too dark. With our shade dry, our Boremanite Devil Legate Marshal is now battle ready, looking ready to defend the Garmon Cluster from the traitor legions. You could stop here and use these steps on the rest of your cohort, or you can keep watching for three more extra steps to take your model to the next level. To add a bit of extra detail to the void suit, we'll highlight the raised areas and folds with the Administratum Grey. We want nice thin lines, so we'll make sure that we get a point to a small layer brush by rolling it on the palette after thinning our paint. This also helps us control the amount of paint that we have on our brush too. Now our brush is pointed, we can add those small lines. Remember to get the ones between the leather straps on the arms and around the back of the legs too. Now our first highlight is done, let's add our second. For all our metallics, we'll highlight them with Stormhost Silver. Just like with the void suit, we want to highlight the raised areas and edges, making those lines look worn and lighter in general, by just highlighting those top areas and leaving some areas that are hidden by other details, we can create an illusion of light on our model. And for our last highlight, we'll use Death Guard Green to pick out any edges of the plate armour. We can pick out the elevated leg plates and also pick out the inner areas, creating a gap where the recessed shade sits and the lighter green of the armour. Just take your time and keep that brush pointed, and this detail will be painted in no time at all. And there we are, our Boremanite Devils Legate Marshal is looking noble and ornate, ready to defend their home cluster alongside the Iron Hands. We based our Marshal with Astrogranite, and if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, we have videos all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or head to your local Warhammer store, where amazing staff would be happy to help you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!